have you been doing, children? I trust that you're all doing well. You know, we've been learning a lot of different practical lessons all these last Sundays. We've been learning about our actions and our attitudes, about being honest, about being obedient, about being industrious, about being reliable. And what do you think we're going to learn this morning? We're going to learn about how to be teachable. How to be teachable? Well, you know what, children? We definitely need to give you all the credit, because Sunday after Sunday, you intently listen to the Sunday school lessons. We really thank you for your patience. Lamech, don't you think they all deserve a round of applause?
Yes, they do.
Yes, indeed, children. We thank you for your patience. Ever since the lockdown has been announced since March, and ever since the virtual Sunday school started in April, you have been patiently listening to all the Sunday school lessons. And we thank God for that, that we can connect with you every Sunday after Sunday virtually, right? We thank the Lord for it. And before we go into our lesson time, let's pray. Dear Lord, we just want to thank you for this time, for this new day that you've given us, Lord. Thank you for your faithfulness, which is new every morning. Thank you for keeping us safe from any harm or danger, Lord. And even as we move into our lesson time, I pray that you speak to each one of us. Be with us. We give you glory. In Jesus' name, we ask and pray. Amen. Okay, Lamech, what do we have here?
That's a keyboard.
Okay, let me try my hand at it. Let's see. Well, I don't seem to be good at this.
I can help you with that, Mom.
Yes? Sure, please. Job, Lamech.
Thank you.
I wasn't that good at the keyboard, but I think you definitely did a good job.
Thank you.
And Lamech, may I ask you, how much time did it take for you to practice the song?
It took me 2 to 4 hours.
And may I know who taught you the song?
I saw it on YouTube.
Oh, so Lamech has learned the song by playing the song on YouTube. Wow. I must say, children, you are so blessed. You know, you can just go onto YouTube and you can learn whatever you like, right? You know what, children? This keyboard was gifted to me when I was 18 years old. It was my 18th birthday gift by my parents. At that time, I was sent for keyboard classes. You know, I used to go 2 days during the week for keyboard classes. But well, somehow during the course of learning, I somehow lost the interest and I never pursued the learning the keyboard. My parents counseled me and they said, why don't you go back? Why don't you go back and learn, start learning again? But I was just too busy with my studies and I just got so involved with my studies that I just didn't pursue learning the keyboard any longer. You know what, children? You are at such a, you know, in these times, in these challenging times, you're at home, of course you're having your online classes, but you all have a chance to learn something online, just like Lamech did. You know, he took a few hours and learned the keyboard while watching the keyboard, you know, playing the keyboard and watching it online through YouTube. Well, you are such a privileged generation. Although I had made that mistake, you know, We teach a lot. We tell our children so many things that we counsel and guide them to do a lot of things. But somehow I did not listen to the counsel of my parents at that time. Probably if I did that, I would have mastered the keyboard like Lamech did just now, right children? And you know what? We learn a lot of things. We learn. Learning is a process. Every day, I'm sure you're learning something new in your online classes. And when you're given an assignment, a project, what do? You go on the net. You read a lot of books. You know, when we, during our times, when we used to learn, about a new project or about a new topic, well, we used to learn by reading a lot of books. You know, I remember when I was reading about the human body, I looked up on the encyclopedia. And I wanted to know more about the human body. So I read a lot about it through the book, right? And I'm sure you all also learn in different ways. Learning has definitely evolved with times. You have the internet at your fingertips where you can learn a lot of things, right? Lamech, I remember you were just a few days ago. You were learning a few lessons and you were learning new words in English.
Yes.
Can you tell me about that? How did you learn?
I learned it from the dictionary.
Oh, the dictionary. So, I remember how we used to learn when we learned new words from the dictionary. I remember how exciting it would be for us, you know, to look up the dictionary and find. Is this the same dictionary you use, Lamech, or you went on Google to find new words?
Oh, no, Mom. This was the dictionary I used.
And what was your experience of learning things from the dictionary?
That it was the first time that and there were so many words and so many meanings to learn.
Okay. It was an exciting time for Lamech to search. When I used to search, I used to see, I didn't know that the dictionary had so many words that we could learn from. Right, children? I mean, I used to get so excited when we used to learn new words from the dictionary. And you know, children, there are a lot of other ways that we learn. We learn just by watching. We learn by listening. Isn't it, Lamech?
Yes.
We also learn by exploring. Right? That's right. I remember, you know, we used to watch our mom do a lot of things around the house and we learned a lot of things, you know, by just watching her, how she would cook and things like that. And not just that, children, I'm sure each one of you at your home, you probably might be learning by as to how to use the vacuum cleaner. There is a process that you follow. There are a few steps that your parents might teach you. You plug in the vacuum cleaner, then you turn on the switch, and then you tidy your home. I'm sure your parents tell you, you know, today is the day you have to clean up your room. You do the same thing. You plug in, you turn on the switch, and then you tidy your room, right? And during your online classes, how do you actually learn new things? You'll do by listening. You'll listen to every word that your teacher says. I'm sure back when you were going to school, you would listen to what she would write down. You would watch and you would see what she's writing down on the blackboard. And there are many ways. Now, you know, even the schools have become digital. You're probably having a laptop to learn in school. You listen, you watch, and you learn. And there is another way that we learn, and that is by exploring, right? Maybe I remember, Lamech, going on a field trip to with your school. Can you share about that experience, Lamech?
Yeah, sure.
Yes. Tell me about it.
From school, we went to a place called Pottery's Village.
Okay.
So we made pots from clay.
All right.
We molded them.
Okay.
And we dried them.
Uh-huh.
And we molded them on the potter's wheel.
Oh, right. That's nice.
And after we dried them, we wrote our names.
Oh, wow.
And that's how I explored the Pottery Village.
Wow. That must have been a good experience.
Yes, it was.
I remember you bought those small pots back home, right?
Yes.
The pots that he actually made on the potter's wheel. I'm sure that was such a nice experience, you know, molding the clay on the potter's wheel, just like God molds us day after day, right, children? It's such a good experience.
Yes.
Every day, just the way the potter, you know, he does the pottery, God is working on us, teaching us, disciplining us in many ways, right? What are the ways that we just learned, Lamech? We learnt by watching, by listening, and by exploring. And what are the other ways that we learn? We also learn by discipline. May I bring to your attention what Proverbs chapter 3 verses 11 and 12 says? It says, "My child, don't reject the Lord's discipline and don't be upset when he corrects you." Verse 12 says, "For the Lord corrects those he loves, just as the father corrects a child in whom he delights." That's right, children. I'm sure many a times, you know, our parents discipline us for our good. Just like I remember how my parents would try to counsel me and say, "You know what, if you learn the keyboard, it'll be for your good. Maybe tomorrow you can, you know, play in your family time, in your worship time, in your quiet time." But somehow I didn't do that. But I encourage you, children, when your parents counsel you and discipline you, it's for your good. It's definitely for your good. Lamech, may I ask you of any experience when your parents disciplined you?
Yes. In my school, I had to score some marks.
Okay.
And I didn't do it.
Alright.
So my parents disciplined me by taking away my cycle for the week.
Oh, for a week. That must have been painful, Lamech.
Yes.
So what did you do?
So I worked hard that week.
Okay.
And the next week my parents gave me back
your
cycle.
And what did you feel after that lesson?
I felt very good.
Okay, because what their parents did, what Lamech's parents did was, they tried to discipline him. You know, cycling is something that Lamech really loves, isn't
yes.
it? And what did his parents do? We just try to discipline him by, you know, taking away the privilege of cycling for a week so that he could concentrate on his studies. Just as Proverbs had said, God delights in you and he wants to discipline you for your good. Right, children? And thank you so much, Lamech, for sharing your experience.
Thank you.
As we move on, Proverbs chapter 10 verse 17 says, "People who accept discipline are on the pathway to life, but those who ignore discipline or correction will go astray." Proverbs 15 verse 32 also says, "If you reject discipline, you only harm yourself. But if you listen to correction, you grow in understanding." So that lesson taught you,
yes.
right? Even though your parents were trying to discipline you,
yes.
it was for your good. And
yes.
then you went on to score good marks, right? We learn from our mistakes. We learn sometimes from others' mistakes. You know, we learn by watching, by listening, by exploring. There are many ways that we learn. But I want to bring your attention to a life of one king from the Bible. And who is that king? That king is King Rehoboam. And who was King Rehoboam? He was the son of King Solomon. You know, the great King Solomon. When he died, what happened to his kingdom? Was it given away to someone? No. His son, King Rehoboam, took over King Solomon's kingdom. And he was a young king. He didn't have any experience on ruling his kingdom. But still, he was looking unto God and to the counsel of many people around him. So at one point, there were some people from his kingdom who came to King Rehoboam and they asked him, "King, we are from your kingdom and we have a request." So King Rehoboam said, "Yes, please tell me what it is." And then they said, "Could you please lower our tax and our workload? There's too much of work and there's too much of taxes that we are paying." Then King Rehoboam said, "Okay, I will think about it and I will get back to you on this matter." So what did King Rehoboam do? He was young. He didn't really have a lot of experience in dealing with different issues in the kingdom. So he went to the older advisors in his kingdom, the same people that his father, King Solomon, used to take advice from. So King Rehoboam went to these older advisors and asked, "What should I do? The people of our kingdom have come for advice and they asked me to lower the tax rates and to lower the workload." So the older advisors told him, "See, I think you need to be kind to your people, to your people who belong to your kingdom. You should go ahead and lower the taxes and lower the workload, decrease it, so that they will be faithful and serve you for the rest of their lives. So Rehoboam thought for a moment, and then he went to the young advisors in his kingdom, and he asked the same question to them. And what did they say? The young advisors said, "You are the king, you can rule, you can say anything that you want." So what did the young advisors say, Lamech? Did you know what they said? The young advisors said, "You are the king, just tell them you cannot decrease the workload, you cannot decrease their taxes. They will have to work hard and do everything they can for the, you know, for the betterment of the kingdom." And what do you think King Rehoboam must have done? You know what he did, Lamech? King Rehoboam unfortunately listened to the advice and the counsel of the young advisors. And it so happened that the 10 tribes, the people who belonged to the 10 tribes of King Rehoboam, just left his kingdom. He was left with nothing. All the people who were working hard and faithfully serving him, they just left him. Can you imagine, from the 12 tribes of Israel, there were 10 tribes who just left King Rehoboam. It was so unfortunate that he listened to the advice of those young advisors from his kingdom instead of listening to those experienced advisors who used to also, you know, advise his father. It was so unfortunate that he lost his kingdom and he couldn't do anything much as a king. So children, when our parents and when our elders, you know, help us and counsel us, we need to give heed to their advice, because they do it for our good. You might ask, "Ma'am, how do I differentiate between good advice and bad advice? What is the benchmark? What is the standard for me to understand which is good advice for me and which is not a good advice for me?" You know, the only standard that we have for us is the instruction of God, which is the Holy Bible. Yes, children, I just want to encourage you. You need to compare everything, every instruction and every counsel that comes to you from the Word of God, because the Word of God never fails us. Right, Lamech? When we have problems, when we need counsel, we go to godly people. We go first to our parents. And I encourage you, children, do go to your parents. Meditate on the Word of God, which is the best thing that we can go to. We can dig into the Word of God, because there is no instruction better than the Word of God. You know, at the age that you are, you know, sometimes you may be carried away. Your friends will say, "You know what, have you listened to that music, Lamech? Maybe have you listened to, you know, did you buy that kind of clothes? You didn't buy that kind of clothes. Oh, then you will not be popular and nobody will look at you. Nobody will want to be your friend." You know what, children, just stay away from friends like that. That's when you look to the Word of God and you ask God to guide you and ask God to help you. To when you meditate, when you start looking for godly advice and when you start going to people who think of your good, definitely God will guide you. And when God starts to guide you, you are so teachable, right? When you look to God's Word, He teaches you from His Word. So I encourage you, children, look to the Lord all the time, at all times, and His Word, because His Word is yes and amen. And before that, we go on, I just want to encourage you, go by what the Word of God says. And today's memory verse, it says from Proverbs chapter 12, verse 15, it says, "Fools think their own way is right, but the wise listen to others." And the wise people that you have around is your godly parents, right? Your Sunday school teachers, maybe the fellowship that you go to, maybe the care cell that you attend. You need to go and you need to seek God at places such as these, where you will get good advice and good counsel. And when you become teachable and when God sees that you are learning from godly people, He will start building you up. He will start equipping you, right? And then people will start coming to you for advice. Imagine, you might just think, "I'm just so young. Who will come to advise?" Your friends will start coming to you by seeing your walk with God, right? So when you are teachable, God teaches you so that you can be a blessing to many around you, children. So I encourage you, be blessed. And you know, I pray that the Lord will help you at these times. And even as we close, let's look to the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord, we just want to thank you for this time, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for helping us to be teachable. Thank you, Lord, that your word teaches us so many things, that we can look to your word, which is the standard for us, Lord. We don't need to go to anyone else but your word, Lord. And the Holy Spirit, which speaks to us through your word, which comes alive, Master. We want to thank you. Thank you for teaching us about getting good counsel from our parents, from our godly friends, Master. Equip us, Lord, so that we can be a bold witness unto you, Lord. And as we close, we give you glory for this time, and we thank you for your name. In Jesus' name we ask and pray. Amen. Amen. So children, before we close, I encourage you that just below the lesson time is the activity sheet. So when you have time, please download it and you can do the activity. Alright, so until we see you, stay safe, God bless you, and have a blessed Sunday.
Bye. Bye-bye.